bill, expected today at mid-afternoon. Pennsylvania Democrat Joe Sestak, my guest from Capitol Hill now, a candidate for the Senate in Pennsylvania as well. And sir, good morning to you. Thank you for taking time with
Good to be here today, Bill.
You know, I tell you, I don't know if I'm looking forward to this news this afternoon or if I'm going to dread it. I mean, is this number going to be so high it's going to scare off a lot of lawmakers?
It should not, as long as that number is deficit neutral. And that's the key here. First, I'm concerned that the way the Finance Services Committee has approached it, they aren't going to cover everyone. And second, if they haven't paid for it, that's also a second sin. If they meet both those criteria and it's deficit neutral, then I say we need to meld it with the House bill and see what the best deficit-neutral approach to cover everyone gives America.
Let's talk reality here. I mean, based on what we're hearing, is there any way this thing's deficit-neutral?
No. I haven't seen what the CBO score is. In fact, I couldn't see your screen what their numbers are. My concern is that the CBO will score that this bill in the Finance Committee does add to the debt. And if it does, you've got to go back to the drawing board and find a way to cover it. The only way they're doing it now is by taxing the insurance companies on higher value insurance plans. What we did is a tough decision, but we did apply a surtax to those who are more able to afford a surtax to cover it. Ours was deficit neutral, except for the 21% Medicare cut for physicians, which would have occurred anywhere, and
okay.
I believe we Democrats should have covered that.
I got you. I don't know what it's going to look like in the end, but this is what I see every time you go off to the CBO. The CBO comes back and says, hey, man, it's a lot higher than you think. You said something in your first answer, that the number of people insured under this program won't be nearly as high as you would like to see. It looks like if you get a health care reform bill passed through Congress right now, out of 300 million Americans, we're going to insure about 20 more million Americans. I mean, you do the math on that. Are people going to be satisfied with that?
No. What we have is about 40 million Americans who are uninsured right now and about 26 million Americans that are underinsured. But the point is not the number. The point really is the impact on an economy. We lose $260 billion every year in lost productivity because of the under and the uninsured. If we don't cover them all, it's not just a moral issue. It has to do with our economy and going forward.
Well, every
That's
plan
why
I've
this
seen,
number has to be covered.
Every plan I've seen is far from that. And every plan that I'm aware of right now, be it on the House side or the Senate side, I'm trying to figure out what's in it for most Americans, okay? Most Americans, 85%, 90% of Americans who pay taxes and they obey the law and they're looking for guidance and direction on this issue. What's in it for them other than more taxes or, as some Democrats like to say, more fees?
Here's what's in it, two issues. Bill, you have private health care insurance. But in your plan, if you're in a family of four, you pay $1,100 today, more annually, to cover the uninsured when they go to an emergency room, passes it to the insurance company, and passes it on to you. So you are being taxed indirectly. Second, 14,000 Americans every day lose their health care plan. That's the equivalent of Bethlehem or Reading or Allentown in Pennsylvania. Every week, everyone losing their health care. So if you have health care, you should love the House bill, because with the public option that's not funded by the government, it is a choice, not a mandate. We are going to bring in a low premium option that you can pick from to begin to break up the OPEC cartel approach in Pennsylvania, where two companies have 70% of all health care plans and dictate the price. We want you, Bill, to hold on to your health plan.
I understand.
That's why the bill is good.
Strategy. We'll see where that goes, if it goes anywhere, once the two sides of Congress come together. Joe Sestak is a Democrat from Pennsylvania. We appreciate you coming on today.
Thanks,